Here we study the photoelectric effect experimentally. Means we are going to study the photoelectric effect by some experimental arrangement. This experimental arrangement consists of a quartz or a glass tube. This is the evacuated glass tube made up of a quartz material or glass material. It is provided with a window that is called quartz window. Through the quartz window, we allow the light from the monochromatic source. This is the monochromatic source of light which emits the monochromatic light. Now, this evacuated glass tube is containing the two plates. One plate is called here, one plate is the photosensitive plate, and another plate is the collector plate. This photosensitive plate is connected to the negative terminal, as well as the collector plate is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Here, what is the meaning of photosensitive plate? Photosensitive plate means it is made up of a material, the material which is sensitive for the photoelectric effect, means which can emit the electrons when it is exposed to the light of small frequencies only. Means even for visible light, even when visible light is incident on a metal surface, it can emit the electrons like alkali metals. What are the alkali metals? Lithium, sodium, potassium, cesium, rubidium. These are alkali metals. These alkali metals are photosensitive metals. Means these can emit the electrons with visible light only. Visible light having the some less energy compared to the ultraviolet radiation or X-rays, gamma rays, etc. Now these are photosensitive metals. Now the plate made up of these materials is a photosensitive plate which can emit the electrons even with the visible light also. Now C is the photosensitive plate. Now when this photosensitive plate is exposed to the monochromatic light, then it emits the electrons. The electrons which are emitted then are collected by the collector plate A. Here the polarity of collector plate A can be changed by using the arrangement commutator. Here is the commutator which is used to change the polarity of the collector plate, emitter plate, and also collector plate. Here C is the emitter plate which is emitting the electrons. That's why it is called emitter plate, and A is the collector plate which is collecting the electrons. So here the polarities of emitter plate and collector plate can be changed by using the arrangement called commutator. And here the electrons which are received by the collector plate flows in the external circuit that causes the electric current to flow in the external circuit. The electric current in the external circuit is read by the microammeter. Why we are using microammeter? Because this current is in the order of microamperes. It is a very small current. That is the reason why we are using the microammeter. And to measure the potential difference between the collector plate and emitter plate, we are using a voltmeter. And also using the arrangement of rheostat, we can change the voltages of the collector plate. The voltage of collector plate can be changed with respect to emitter plate using the rheostat arrangement. Using the rheostat, we can change the potential of the collector plate with respect to the emitter plate. To this collector plate, we can give positive potential and negative potential also using the commutator arrangement. And the positive potential of this collector plate or negative potential can be changed using the rheostat arrangement. Now this is the experimental arrangement to study the photoelectric effect. Now let us see using this how we study the experimentally photoelectric effect. Now here S is the source of monochromatic light. Now it emits the monochromatic light. This monochromatic light is allowed to pass through the quartz window and allowed to fall on the photosensitive plate. Now this photosensitive plate emitting the electrons, these electrons are collected by the collector plate. This collector plate receiving the electrons, and these electrons are flowing in the external circuit causing the electric current. This electric current is called here photocurrent, and the electrons are called here photoelectrons. The electrons which are emitted photoelectrons, these photoelectrons causing the electric current in the external circuit, this is called photocurrent. The photocurrent is measured using the microammeter here. Yes, in this way we study the experimentally photoelectric effect. Now here we are going to study the what is the effect of the intensity of incident radiation on the photocurrent. How does photocurrent changes with the intensity of the incident monochromatic light? Here, first of all, what is meant by intensity? Intensity is nothing but intensity basically defined as the amount of energy radiated, the amount of energy incident emitted per unit cross sectional area and unit time. The amount of energy emitted per unit cross sectional area and per unit time is called here intensity. Now we are varying the intensity means we are varying the energy here. Energy is a varying means here. Number of photons are varying here. Here for one photon energy is h nu. Suppose light is containing n number of photons, n into h nu by area into time. Here intensity is varied by changing the number of photons. For a fixed frequency of incident radiation, suppose for incident radiation frequency nu is fixed, nu is constant. If nu is fixed, then intensity can be changed by changing the number of photons. Means here intensity is changing means number of photons is changing here for a fixed frequency of incident radiation. At a fixed frequency of incident radiation, intensity is increasing nothing but number of photons are increasing. Here we are changing the intensity means we are changing the number of photons that are going to strike the photosensitive plates. Intensity is increasing means more number of photons are striking the unit area of the photosensitive plate in unit time. Here intensity is decreasing means less number of photons are going to strike the unit area of the photosensitive plate in unit time. Now we are going to study the variation of photocurrent with the intensity of incident light. Now that can be studied like this. For example, as we increase the intensity, we are increasing means we are increasing intensity means the number of photons striking the unit area of the photosensitive plate in unit time are increasing. If more number of photons strike the emitter plate, then what happens? More number of electrons will be released. Why? Because this photoelectric emission is the one-to-one process. One-to-one process means one photon collides with the one electron. During the collision, photon give up its energy to the electron. So that when more number of photons strike the photosensitive plate, more number of electrons are released. If more number of electrons are released, the more number of electrons causes a more amount of current in the external circuit. Means as intensity increases, the photocurrent also increases linearly. Means there is direct proportionality between the intensity and intensity of incident light and photocurrent. If we plot a graph between photocurrent small I is taken on y-axis and intensity of incident light is taken on x-axis, as intensity increases, the photocurrent also increases here. Means the photocurrent increases linearly. The photocurrent increases linearly with the intensity of incident light. We are increasing intensity means we are increasing the number of photons that are going to strike the unit area of the photosensitive plate in unit time. If more number of photons strikes, then more number of electrons will be released. If more number of electrons released, that causes more amount of current in the external circuit. So like this, as a intensity increases, the photocurrent increases linearly. This is the graph which shows a variation of photocurrent with the intensity of incident light. Later on we study the effect of potential of the collector plate on the effect of potential of a collector plate on the photocurrent.